This week's edition of Retro Radio is coming to you live from the studios of WJCU.
Celebrating 16 years on WJCU, Retro Radio is next.
Now, a Retro Radio special presentation. Ray King, 60 years of love and radio, starts now.
50 years ago today.
This is Ray Glasser speaking. On Saturday, April 18th, 1970. Exactly 10 years ago today, I first spoke over AM radio. That date and day was Tuesday, April 18th, 1960. At that time, I was 12 years old, just entering junior high school, and radio to me at that time was a novelty, something different. 10 years later, here in 1970, I've decided to make radio and television my career, my profession. What I intend to do right now, on April 18th, 1970, exactly 10 years later, is to do what I'm going to call a WMFH simulation. The station I was on 10 years ago was WMFH, the MFH standing for Mayfield Heights, a suburb of Cleveland, Ohio. The station was on 540 kilocycles on the AM band and 104.2 on the FM band, later to be moved to 98.0 megacycles on the FM dial. At this time, I'm going to play some of the songs I might have played back then in 1960. I may add that the records I'm using were the exact, or are the exact same records I did use 10 years ago on WMFH. I've kind of planned this for a couple of weeks now, this being a more or less posterity tape. So here is my WMFH simulation, made 10 years later, April 18th, 1970.
And that's what I did 50 years ago today in 1970 to celebrate 10 years since I had been on WMFH. And here we are 50 years later in 2020 celebrating 60 years. This is Ray King on WJCU University Heights, welcoming you to a very special three-hour retro radio show as I celebrate 60 years of loving radio, and today is the actual 60th anniversary of the first time I spoke over AM radio. In the background, you're hearing the station's theme song, Theme from a Summer Place by Percy Faith, which turned out to be the number one song of 1960. 1960 and WMFH hold very special and personal memories for me, which I'll be sharing with you over the next 3 hours. I'm recording today's show on both audio and video for posterity. And for the first time ever, I'll be playing both MP3s and vinyl here in the studio. And if this isn't enough, today is also Vinylthon 2020, as I'll be joining other college stations around the country who will be playing vinyl on their shows as well. Stay with me and enjoy 3 hours of radio and musical nostalgia. I cannot play that song without getting a tear in my eye because we signed on and signed off with that song every night on WMFH, so I heard it at least 10 times a week. Back in the late 50s and early 60s, disc jockeys used theme songs for their shows and actually gave their shows names. When I began on WMFH in April of 1960, I named my show Moody Time and used a song that took me 40 years to find on vinyl. On the BNF label, it's called Heavenly, performed by bandleader Lou Douglas, and was from February of 1960, and here it is from vinyl. And that was my first theme song on WMFH, Heavenly by Lou Douglas. I actually found that song thanks to a website that's long gone called GEMM, G-E-M-M.com, which was a worldwide locator for records and CDs that were really rare. And after a lot of searching, I found a copy of that, believe it or not, a DJ copy in Italy. Cost me $40, but it was certainly worth it. After about a month, I wanted to hear something more upbeat on WMFH and a better name for my show than Moody Time. So I changed the show's name to Music Matinee and found another instrumental to use. It was called Lingering Lovers by Eric Rogers, and here it is on vinyl. Yes, boy, are these songs hitting me. That's Eric Rogers and Lingering Lovers, my second theme song on WMFH.
Hi, this is Shotgun Tom Kelly here in Los Angeles. I'd like to wish my buddy Ray King a happy 60th anniversary of Love and Radio. Now, Ray's biggest fan, Tony Pepper, wanted to make sure that I said some real nice things about Ray. Because if I didn't,
he was going to be thoroughly disappointed.
Now, Tony would like me to tell you one thing, and I'd like to tell you that one thing, too. And that one thing is, keep on cooking, Ray King!
Thank you so much, Shotgun Tom Kelly. You can hear Shotgun on Sirius XM 60s on 6 channel weekdays from 7 midnight Eastern Time. You are taking a trip back in time to Ray King's beginnings in radio, 1960. WMFH, the station that I was on, did broadcast at 540 on the AM radio dial, and for a while we simulcasted on FM. WMFH was a carrier current radio station, meaning that our signal was carried piggyback on the local power lines in our neighborhood, so you actually had to have your radio set parallel to the power lines on your street to hear us. Although I do remember distinctly hearing us on our car radio. We were licensed by the FCC, and we even had to fill out program logs daily showing the exact time that our shows went on the air, off the air, and the exact times that we signed on and off and so forth. An example of one of our program logs is featured on our Retro Radio Facebook page at facebook.com/retroradiostation. The songs I'll be playing today are the exact same songs I played on WMFH in 1960, although they won't be played in any kind of chronological order. Many of the songs we played were actually from 1959. And we played lots and lots of instrumentals. Here is the very first song that we played on WMFH at 7 p.m. on Monday, April 18th, 1960, 60 years ago today, right after Brian Breen's theme song. It's a 1959 Ricky Nelson hit called I Wanna Be Loved.
Well, I know somewhere there's bound.
Oh yeah, the very first song we played on WMFH 60 years ago today, Ricky Nelson and I Wanna Be Loved. I just got a few phone calls are starting to come in and I really would love to hear from you. 216-397-4438 is the number. I just heard from my buddy Del from Brooklyn, a loyal listener, and Jimmy from the Current Outsiders. Jimmy, thanks so much for calling, guys. Here's another song we played in the spring of 1960 on the ABC Paramount label of Steve Lawrence and Pretty Blue Eyes.
Thought I was in love before, Pretty Blue Eyes.
Hi, everybody. It's Big Jim Edwards, formerly of the Big 8 CKLW. Let's go back 60 years. 60 years ago, the price of a first-class stamp was 4 cents. The price of a regular gallon of gas was 31 cents. A dozen eggs would cost you 57 cents. A gallon of milk was 49 cents. And one thing never changed. Ray King, Rockin' Ray, he's priceless. Congratulations, Ray, on 60 years of rockin' and rollin'.
Thank you so much, Big Jim Edwards, formerly of the Big 8 CKLW. Oh, yeah, another Steve Lawrence hit. It's called Girls, Girls, Girls.
They sing about Donna and Peggy Sue.
Betty, Zaza.
Oh, yeah, definitely on vinyl. Steve Lawrence and Girls, 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 and that is a DJ copy that is totally worn out, I tell you right now. It's 2:20 on Retro Radio. Ray King, celebrating 60 years of Lovin' Radio. 60 years ago today was the very first time I spoke over AM radio, and from that day forward up until today and beyond, it's been in my blood. What can I tell you? Also from April of 1960, here's a Johnny Horton song about the movie Sink the Bismarck. Yeah, Johnny Horton from the 1960 movies Think the Bismarck, and we played that a lot back in April of 1960 on WMFH. Want to thank all of you who have called or tried to call in. I actually just heard from the sister of my buddy Jack. It was her house that we had the station in the basement on Summit Drive in Mayfield Heights. Always good to hear from her. And of course, my buddy and loyal listener Rob called in from Buffalo, New York. Thanks for tuning into this very, very special show, guys. 2:24 on a Saturday with Ray King.
May 1960.
Here's a really big, big, big chill song for me. We played this a lot. On the Vista label, here's Annette with Oh Dio Mio.
Oh Dio Mio.
Oh, what a beautiful song. I love that song. Annette and Oh Dio Mio. And you may know that there's actually an Italian language version of that song that she did also in 1960.
1960.
Big summertime hit in 1960. Here's Sammy Cooke. Chain Gang on Retro Radio with the King.
I hear something saying, my, my, my.
Hey, boo-boo.
It's love now.
listening to a retro radio special. Ray King's 60 Years of Love and Radio on WJCU University Heights.
Old gold. 1960.
It's 2:30 at Retro Radio. This is Ray King, taking you back to the year that I began in radio, 1960. Here's one of the summertime 1960 hits we played for Johnny Burnett. It's Dreamin'.
Dreamin'. Woo.
Johnny Burnett with a big 1960 hit called Dreamin'.
Hi, Fly Shelf's Funny Farm. I would love to wish my buddy Ray King a happy 60 years of love and radio. So you keep on rocking, Ray. He's got stacks and stacks and wax and wax. He's got to pick the click and once watch oldies but goodies, newies but goodies. You got it.
Thank you so much, my good buddy Flash Phelps from Sirius XM. You know, instrumentals were very big in the 1950s and 60s, and we played our share on WMFH. Here's one from band leader Richard Maltby from 1959 on vinyl. It's a ballad of Al Capone. Oh yeah, Richard Maltby and the Ballad of Al Capone. We played two other songs by him, which we'll be getting to later on in the show. Here's another one of the 1960 hits we played from singer-songwriter Teddy Randazzo. This peaked at number 44 on Billboard in 1960 on the ABC Paramount label. It's The Way of a Clown.
April 1960.
Back when he was known as Ricky Nelson in the 50s and 60s, he had a lot of hits, and we played some from him back on 1960 WMFH radio. Here's one called Young Emotions.
Young.
We can.
You are listening to Vinylthon. Vinylthon. Vinylthon.
Because in vinyl, we trust.
Old gold.
We played a lot of songs from the 1959 Four Preps album, Dancing and Dreaming, and here they are, from side one, track one, with their version of All I Have to Do is Dream.
When I want you.
Oh, is that pretty? The Four Preps from 1959 on All I Have to Do is Dream, and that's one of the very few stereo songs you'll be hearing today on Retro Radio. It's going to be almost an all-mono show. I actually picked up that album at a place in Columbus that was around for years and years, that's long gone, called Robertson Company. It's on the south end of town, or was in the south end of town, by the Air Force Base, and it was a two-story record warehouse. The place was huge, and they specialize in rare vinyl, and that's where I found a lot of songs, actually, that I'm playing today. 244 on Retro Radio with Ray King. Up next, Andy Williams.
1960, Ray!
If I say I love you, do you mind? I love you, do you mind?
Oh yeah, Andy Williams on the Cadence label and Do You Mind?
Hi, this is Chelsea Lyons of Cleveland Star 102. I'd like to congratulate Ray King on his 60 years of loving radio. Keep on rockin', Ray, and stay groovy.
Here we go. Vinyl gang, vinyl. Back then we called them Ferrante. It was actually Ferrante and Teicher. On vinyl, here's Dream Concerto on Retro Radio as we go back to 1960. Yes, yes, big finish. Ferrante and Teicher and Dream Concerto on vinyl, and that was a DJ copy that's totally worn out. You know, besides doing my special 60-year show today, today is also Vinylthon 2020. A lot of college and non-commercial stations are also playing vinyl on their shows today. And it's also National Record Store Day. Have a lot of things going on today. Up next, I've got Connie Stevens.
May 1960.
On the Warner Brothers label here, 16 Reasons. Oh yeah, we played that song a lot. Connie Stevens and 16 Reasons. Up next, Bob and Joe and Stood Up. That's what it's called. Stood Up on vinyl.
Stood Up. Stood Up.
On vinyl, Bob and Joe and Stood Up.
1960.
the golden year, 1960.
Here's a guy who had many, many hits for many, many years, and this is the one we played on WMFH in the summer of 1960. On the Columbia label, in stereo, a really pretty song. One of the few stereo songs you'll be hearing today. It's Johnny Mathis and My Love for You. Wow. Wow, what a song. Johnny Mathis and My Love for You. Up next, I have the one big hit for them 3 G's called Let's Go Steady for the Summer.
Ray G!
Let's go steady for the summer.
Church bells may ring.
Take this ring, this ring of mine.
You're listening to a retro radio special. Ray King's 60 Years of Love and Radio on WJCU University Heights.
Old gold.
1960. It's 3 o'clock at Retro Radio. This is Ray King taking you back to 1960 with the music I played on WMFH. Here's Bobby Darin.
Hear them bells, hear them bells.
Oh, yeah, on the Decca label, Bobby Darin and Hear Them Bells, recorded first in 1956 and re-released in 1959. This is Ray King with a special three-hour retro radio show, playing some of the songs I played 60 years ago in 1960 on my first radio gig, WMFH in Mayfield Heights. This hour, I'll tell you how the station got its start, the two newspaper articles that were published about us, and why it only lasted 5 months. But now, another one of the many instrumentals that we played on WMFH. Here's one of the tunes we played from bandleader Richard Maltby from the 1959 movie. Here's a theme from the FBI story on vinyl. What a big chill song that was for me. We played that a lot. Richard Maltby and the theme from the FBI story. I've gotten a call from all the outsiders today, the current Cleveland band, the Outsiders. I want to thank you guys so much for supporting me and the radio stations I'm on and for giving us some wonderful music. 306 on a Saturday with Ray King.
Hi, this is Shotgun Tom Kelly here in Los Angeles. And I'd like to wish my buddy Ray King a happy 60th anniversary of Love and Radio. Ray began at WMFH in a small 50-watt station in Mayfield Heights, Ohio, in 1960. And still going strong in 2020. Keep on cooking, Ray!
Thank you so much, Shotgun Tom Kelly. What a great radio talent and what an amazing friend. You know, the musical Bye Bye Birdie gave us quite a few popular songs that got airplay on the radio, and we played some of them. Here's one from the Kirby Stone 4 called Kids.
Hi, everybody. This is Kirby Stone.
Kids, 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 kids.
Oh, yeah, from Bye Bye Birdie, the Kirby Stone 4 with Kids.
Weekend weather.
You're listening to Vinyl Thon.
Heard on radio stations around the world.
Because in vinyl, we trust.
It was April 18th.
The Screen Actors Guild, led by future United States President Ronald Reagan, ends its strike against major movie studios.
May 1st.
American spy Gary Francis Powers is shot down while flying a U-2 spy mission over Russia.
March 3rd.
Lucille Ball files for divorce from Desi Arnaz.
May 19th.
The largest anti-nuclear rally ever held in the United States takes place in Madison Square Garden as 17,000 people protest.
It was the spring of 1960, and Ray King remembers.
I think we all do. Big 1960 hit from Don and Phil Everly. On Warner Brothers, here's Kathy's Clown.
Don't want your lovey's clown.
Oh, yeah, Don and That's Phil. Kathy's Big hit on the Warner Brothers label and Kathy's Clown. Let me give you a thumbnail sketch of how WMFH began. My best friend was a guy named Jack who lived on the next street over from me in Mayfield Heights. One of his next-door neighbors was an engineer at WERE Radio, and he had all the equipment necessary to put a radio station on the air. He approached Jack in early 1960 and asked him if maybe he and some of his friends would like to go on the radio. Now, who would say no to that, right? We jumped at the chance, and we went on the air, and it all worked out. We went on the air 60 years ago today, Monday, April 18, 1960, with four guys each doing a half-hour show from 7 to 9 p.m. After school was out for the summer, we added three more guys and increased our hours from 5:30 to 9 p.m. By late August, we were winding down right before school began, just after Labor Day, and our last broadcast was on August 31st, 1960. More about the history of the station later in the show.
June 1960.
Rated number one, 21. For all of 1960, the Brothers Four, here's Greenfields.
One.
The Brothers Four and Greenfields.
Hey, Ray King, it's my king, Ray in Cleveland. Whenever you guys hear a dedication going out to Novi, Michigan, it's probably coming to me. It's Art Volo up here, sometimes referred to as radio's best friend. Try to be nice to everybody. But my buddy Ray has been slaving away behind the mic for 60 years, and I wanted to be there with him. So did a number of his radio friends, but this pandemic has just not made that possible. So we'll have to do it this way. In a special recording, congratulating you, Ray, for a fantastic career. And now let's hear more great music. Thanks, buddy.
I'll tell you, one of the best friends I've ever had, and he knows everybody in radio. That's Art Volo. Thanks, Art. Here's another instrumental that we played. It's the Stan Applebaum Orchestra with Bikini. Oh, yes, Stan Applebaum and Bikini, one of the many instrumentals we played on WMFH 60 years ago. A lot of phone calls coming in today. I can't say thank you enough to everybody. Westside Richie's calling. Rob from Buffalo's calling. And everybody's calling in today. I just got a call a few minutes ago from a man that actually did a show with me here earlier this year, Kevin O'Neill, who's up in Michigan. And he, of course, was on WGAR back in the 70s. Thanks so much for all the calls and all the well wishes, guys, both on the phone and on Facebook. I really appreciate it. 321 on Retro Radio with Ray King.
1959.
From the 1959 Four Press album, Dancing and Dreaming, here they are again with a pretty song that we played a lot. It's called I Get Along Without You Very Well.
I get along with.
Oh yeah, what a big chill song for this guy. The Four Preps and I Get Along Without You Very Well. From the album Dancing and Dreaming, I remember we actually had a battery-powered microphone, which I posted on Facebook earlier today at facebook.com/retroradiostation. One day the battery went dead, and we couldn't talk. We could play music, but we couldn't talk, so we just started playing that album until our engineer friend came over and actually gave us a new battery. 324 at Retro Radio with Ray King. You're taking a trip back to 1960 with me as I celebrate 60 years of Lovin' Radio. Up next, Steve Lawrence.
Rockin' Ray King.
We played that song a lot on WMFH. Played a lot of Steve Lawrence songs, matter of fact. That's Footsteps, Steve Lawrence at 3:26 on a Saturday with Rockin' Ray King. Up next, one of two versions we played of the 1960 hit, Alley Oop.
It was May 23rd. It was the summer of 1960.
And Ray King remembers.
You're listening to a retro radio special, Ray King's 60 Years of Lovin' Radio on WJCU University Heights.
Old gold.
Retro Radio. This is Rockin' Ray King, taking you back in time to 1960, celebrating 60 years of Lovin' Radio. Here's Sonny Gale. Oh, yeah, one of my favorite songs from 1960, Sonny Gale on the Warwick label and her version of the old Willow song, Church Bells May Ring. It's Ray King celebrating with you 60 years of Lovin' Radio and having a great time today. Thank you so much for joining me. Up next, Gary, Gretchen, and Barbara, the Fleetwoods.
I'll never be.
Nice, nice, nice. On the Dalton label, the Fleetwoods and Runaround.
The year, 1960. The month was April.
Here's Richard Maltby one more time. This one's called Don't Go Home. Oh, yeah, very 50s-sounding song right there. Richard Maltby and Don't Go Home.
Weekend weather.
Yeah! It's 3:40 on a Saturday afternoon with Rockin' Ray King, taking you back 60 years with me as I celebrate 60 years of Lovin' Radio. You may recall the novelty records of the 50s and 60s, spearheaded by Dickie Goodman. He gave us the Flying Saucer, the Touchables, Ben Crazy, and all those. Well, we played one on WMFH from 1957 called Outer Space Looters, and it's a riot. Here are parts one and two together from vinyl. Oh yeah, Outer Space Looters, parts one and two by the Mad Martians.
It was the spring of 1960, and Ray King remembers.
Oh boy, do I. One of two songs we played by this lady in 1960, Anita Bryant, on the Carlton label in mono power. Here's Paper Roses, 3:45 on a Saturday with Rockin' Ray King as we celebrate 60 years of Lovin' Radio right here on WJCU.
I realize.
Oh, yeah, one of two songs we played on WMFH from Anita Bryant. We'll have the other one in the next hour. WMFH was actually featured in two Cleveland newspapers, the Cleveland Press and the local Sun Messenger. I still have both articles with pictures, and they're up on our Retro Radio Facebook page at facebook.com/retroradiostation.
August 1960.
The full beginning that is cut from many radio stations today from the summer of 1960. Here's Joanne Campbell, Kooky Little Paradise. Oh yeah, Joanne Campbell, and she was cute, and a Kooky Little Paradise. 3:50 on a Saturday with Rockin' Ray King. This next country and western song had a number one. This next country and western artist had a number one song in early 1960. Coming up next, which sold 3.5 million copies. And it was ranked number 11 for the entire year of 1960. From vinyl, here's Marty Robbins with the complete mono version of El Paso.
Out in the West Texas, goodbye.
Oh yeah, no doubt that is on vinyl. That's the same DJ copy I played in 1960 on Columbia, and the full mono version, there's a stereo mix available of that song, but they actually cut out a verse. Marty Robinson, El Paso.
1960.
Here come the Delicates. We played a couple songs by them. This one's called Too Young to Date. 3:55 on Retro Radio with Ray King, looking back 60 years. Oh yeah, on the UA label, the Delicates and Too Young to Date. And the B-side of that we also played, it was called The Kiss.
Ray King!
Here come Jan and Dean, another summertime hit in 1960 that will be played on WMFH. It's We Go Together, 3:57 on a Saturday. Time is just speeding right by as we take you back to 1960.
Here's love.
Church bells may ring.
Take this ring, Miss Ray of Love.
You're listening to a retro radio special. Ray King's 60 Years of Love and Radio on WJCU University Heights.
Old gold.
1960.
It's 4 o'clock at Retro Radio. This is Ray King beginning the last hour of my look back at 1960 as I celebrate 60 years of Lovin' Radio. Here's a 1960 hit from Connie Francis.
The tears I cried.
Hi, it's Big Jim Edwards from CKLW. Rockin' Ray King, 60 years on the radio. Let's go back to 1960. The Academy Awards, Best Actor went to Burt Lancaster. Best Actress went to Elizabeth Taylor. Best Director was Billy Wilder for The Apartment. The best actor I know is Ray King, 60 years behind the microphone. Congratulations, Rockin' Ray.
Aw, thank you so much, Big Jim Edwards. What a great guy and a class act. And here's that theme song for the 1960 hit movie, The Apartment. Big summertime hit in 1960 when instrumentals were really big. It's Ferrante and Teicher and the huge theme from The Apartment. Wow! Wow! Now that is music. Yes, Ferrante and Teicher and a big hit back in 1960. theme from The Apartment. 4:06 on a Saturday with Rockin' Ray King. You know, there were a number of versions of this next song released in 1960. There was a version by Billy Vaughan, a version by Gary Miles. We played the version from Dean Hawley. It's called Look for a Star. And the record I used was actually a blank label, and the song was rubber stamped on the label. Here it is.
When life doesn't seem worth the living.
Oh, yeah, Dean Hawley and his version of Look for a Star. He actually had a second hit a year later in 1961. It was a pick hit on WHK in the fall of 61 called Pocketful of Rainbows.
Weekend weather.
July 1960.
I'll never forget this song. Here's Brian Hyland.
She was more.
Yes, number one song back in the summer of 1960 and the first hit for Brian Hyland on the Leader label with one of the longest song titles ever, Itsy Bitsy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini. As promised, here's the other version of Alley Oop that we played. This is Dante and the Evergreens. Oh yeah, Dante and the Evergreens on the Madison label, I think, and their version of Alley Oop, and they actually had a second hit in 1960 called Time Machine.
In this rock and roll year of
1960.
Can't do 1960 without these guys. The first big hit for the Ventures. Here's Walk, Don't Run, 4:16 on Retro Radio as we take you back to the summer of 1960. Oh, yeah, on the Dalton label, which was a subsidiary of Liberty Records, the Ventures and Walk, Don't Run. You know, besides being written up in two Cleveland newspapers, WMFH also has a few pages in my buddy Michael Shevsky's book, Cleveland Radio Tales. There's a whole chapter called Air Pirates, and WMFH was the first station mentioned, although we actually did have an FCC license to operate. Mike mentions my name in the book, plus a few quotes that I gave him, including, "We had to worry about school first. We didn't have time for both radio and homework," talking about the fact that we were only on from 7 to 9 p.m., during the school year. I posted this article on our Retro Radio Facebook page at facebook.com/retroradiostation. Here's a fun song that only bubbled under on Billboard. We played it, Skip and Flip. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Skip and Flip and Hully Gully Cha-Cha-Cha. Up next, the very first version of Sealed with a Kiss.
Hi, this is Shotgun Tom Kelly in Los Angeles. I'd like to wish my buddy Ray King a happy 60th anniversary of Lovin' Radio. Ray began at WMFH, a small 50-watt station in Mayfield Heights, Ohio, in 1960. And you know what? He's still going strong in 2020. And we love him. Keep on cooking, Ray.
Oh, thank you much, Shotgun Tom Kelly, my good radio friend. And what a radio personality he is.
Oh, we gotta say.
That is so pretty. The very first version of Seal with a Kiss, those are the four voices. Up next, a 1960 summertime song from a group that would eventually morph into the Outsiders, Tom King and the Starfires and Ring of Love on the Pama label. I have heard from all five members of the current Outsiders today, and I cannot thank you guys enough for supporting me, supporting my Wixie 1260 online radio gig, and enjoying this music today. Right now, we're going to play the DJ copy of Ring of Love with a slightly longer ending than the consumer copy. From 1960 on Pama, Tom King and the Starfires. Yes, those bongos at the end were not on the consumer copy. That is vinyl, the DJ copy of the 1960 Tom King hit with the Starfires, Ring of Love. I heard that Tom King was a student at Shaw High School when he recorded that song. 4:27 on a Saturday as you're in tune with Rockin' Ray King celebrating 60 years of Lovin' Radio.
Ray King!
Here come the Preston Epps and Bongo, Bongo, Bongo.
Old gold.
It's 4:30 at Retro Radio. We are going back to 1960 as Ray King celebrates 60 years of Lovin' Radio. Here's the other King, Elvis, with the number three song of 1960. Cha-cha-cha. Oh, yeah, Elvis with the number one song of the summer of 1960, It's Now or Never. You know, WMFH actually published its own survey, which we call the WMFH Tune Finder, and we ran it off on my dad's home duplicating machine and distributed to copies to two local record stores in Mayfield Heights. I still had the last one that we published, and I published it and scanned it this week on the Retro Radio Facebook page at facebook.com/retroradiostation.
Hi, everybody. It's Big Jim Edwards from CKLW. Let me take you back 60 years. 1960 was the year the NFL Super Bowl was won by Philadelphia over Green Bay by a score of 17-13. The most valuable player, Norm Van Brocklin. But the best player I've ever known and the guy that's playing for you today is the best sport I know. Rockin' Ray King. Keep spinning the hits, buddy.
Thank you so much, Big Jim. Here's a one-hit wonder from the summer of 1960 from the Safaris. It's Image of a Girl. What a great song. On the Eldo label, the Safaris, An Image of a Girl. 4:36, you got Rockin' Ray King taking you back to 1960.
May 1960.
Here's Connie Stevens. It's called Apollo.
Apollo was a rock.
Connie Stevens, Apollo.
Weekend weather.
One last.
Because in vinyl, we trust.
Rockin' Ray King.
Oh, yeah. Here's a fun song we played in the summer of 1960 on the MGM label. It's Mark Denning, and it's called The Lovin' Touch. That's a great song. He had a couple of hits back in the 60s, Mark Denning and The Lovin' Touch. Up next, a 1960 hit based on a cartoon character. Here come the Ivy Three, sometimes called the Ivy Lee Three, with Yogi. The Ivy Three and Yogi.
Hi, Flash Helps Funny Farm. I would love to wish my buddy Ray King a happy 60 years of loving radio. So you keep on rocking, Ray. He's got stacks and stacks and wax and wax. He's got to pick the click and once watch oldies but goodies, newies but goodies. You got it.
Thank you so much, my good buddy Flash Phelps. Here's Anita Bryant's other hit that we played in 1960 in My Little Corner of the World. Yeah, Anita Bryant and In My Little Corner of the World. Here's a group that began as the Vidals in the 50s, then became the Tradewinds, and wound up as the Innocents. From 1960, the Vidals, and now that summer's here. Oh yeah, that's a good one. The Vidals, and now that summer's here. Up next, a number one-hit wonder from the summer of 1960. Larry Vern. Oh, yeah, Larry Vern and a number one song back in the summer of 1960 with Mr. Custer. Here comes Donnie Brooks with Mission Bell. You got it on Retro Radio. Great song from the summer of 1960, Donnie Brooks and Mission Bell. I'm going to squeeze in one more before we wrap this up.
Rockin' Ray King, 1960.
Can't forget this guy. Oh, my goodness. I cannot play that. That's the wrong version of Valari. So let's do this one instead. Chubby Checker with The Twist. Chubby Checker and the Big Dance of 1960, The Twist. This is Rockin' Ray King thanking you for your time this time. Until next time, thank you so much for joining me today on this nostalgic look back of 60 years in the past. In the background is a song that was written by Paul Anka and ultimately became the Johnny Carson Tonight Show theme song, It's Too Sweet by Tootie's Trumpets. There were dozens of songs I just had to leave out today because I can squeeze just so much into 3 hours. Maybe I'll do a part two of this later this year. In the meantime, next week it's back to business as usual as I take you back to 1967 with the hits from the Big 8, CKLW. Stay tuned for Jumpin' Joe's Basement Show coming up next right here on WJCU. Have a great week, stay safe in these crazy times, and we'll see you next Saturday at 3 o'clock. Bye-bye.